Welcome back in our biology session. So we are discussing our lesson, that is respiration in animals. And today in this respiration in the animals, we will start this session with one activity. So in previous video, we have discussed about that we exhale out the carbon dioxide rich air. Okay? And also I have explained that with the help of one activity, we can prove that we are throwing out the carbon dioxide rich air during the exhalation. For that, see here, I am having the freshly prepared lime water. Okay, freshly prepared lime water is there. Now I will blow the air in this with the help of this tube. Okay. So first, before we do blow the air, see the color of the lime water. It is almost looks like a clear water. Okay. Now I will start to blow the air in it. Okay, so we have to do this activity for the some period of the time, and after blowing the air, then after the some time, we can see that the water becomes like this. Okay, the water will get converted into the milky white. Why this happens? Because when the lime water comes in the contact of carbon dioxide, then it get converts into the milky white. So here you can see the color, how the liquid get changed into the milky white. Okay, so from this activity we have proved that we are exhaling out the carbon dioxide oxide air. Okay, so this is all about this activity, and now we will move for the next point from the lesson and the last point from the lesson, that is nothing but what? Respiration in other animals. Okay, so up till now we have discussed about the respiratory system of a human being, but along with the human being there are the certain organisms, there are the certain animals, those who are also doing the respiration process. Okay, each and every living being, living thing is doing the respiration process, whether it is unicellular or whether it is multicellular. So among all these animals, today we are going to discuss about the certain animals, and relating to that animals we will discuss about their respiratory system. So according to the animals, their respiratory organs are also different. So let's see which are the different animals and which are their different respiratory organs. First we will see the respiration in insects. Okay, respiration in insects. So the insects like cockroach and the grasshoppers, okay, that you can see usually in your surrounding. So these are also the living things, and they are also doing the respiration process. Okay, but for doing the respiration process, they are having a different organs. Have you seen that cockroach is having the nose, or the cockroach is having the lungs inside their body? No, cockroach doesn't have a respiratory organ like the human being. They are having a different organ. So which are their organs? So in the cockroach body, there are the air tubes are there. Their whole body is filled with the air tubes, and the air tubes are called as what? Trachea. Okay, that air tubes are called as trachea, and these air tubes are having the opening at the end. Okay, that air tube, suppose this is the cockroach, in the body of a cockroach all like these air tubes are there, and these air tubes are having the holes at their end, and that holes we can see on the body of the insects, and that holes or that openings are called as what? Spiracles. Okay, that holes or the openings are called as what? Spiracles. So with the help of the spiracles, the oxygen rich air goes inside the trachea. With the help of the trachea, the oxygen rich air gets diffused into the whole body. It reaches to the each and every cell, and that oxygen is used for the further respiration process, that is for the breakdown of the food and to release the energy and the carbon dioxide. Okay. Now this same carbon dioxide again comes into the trachea, and with the help of this spiracle, this carbon dioxide is thrown out. Okay. So for human being, we are using the nostrils too for the inhalation and the exhalation. Like that, in the cockroaches or in the insect, there are the spiracles for the exchange of the gases. Okay. So the carbon dioxide air which goes inside the body of the insects with the help of the spiracles. Then it goes into the trachea. With the help of the trachea, it gets diffused, it gets mixed into the whole body and reaches to the each and every part or each and every tissue and the cell. Again, it gets used for the breakdown of the food and release the energy and the carbon dioxide. That carbon dioxide again flows through the body with the help of these spiracles only. Okay, so this is the respiratory system in the insects, like the cockroach and the grasshoppers. Okay. So in the insects, the respiratory organ is what? Spiracles and the
track.
Yeah. Now we will see the next animal, that is for respiration in the earthworm. So as we know that earthworm is living in the soil, and with the help of their moist skin they are doing the respiration. With the help of their moist skin they can do the exchange of the gases like carbon dioxide and the oxygen. Okay. So the respiratory organ in the earthworm is what? Moist skin. Now the next one we will discuss about what? Respiration in frogs. Okay. So as we know, the frog is an amphibian. It means what? It lives in the water also and on the land also. So the frogs are having a different respiratory organ according to their habitat. Whenever the frog is living on the land, the frog is doing the respiration with the help of pair of lungs. Okay, like the human beings are having the pair of lungs, like that the frogs are also having the pair of the lungs, and with the help of that pair of the lungs, the frogs are doing the respiration on the land. While when the frog is in the water, that time they are using their moist skin to do the respiration. So with the help of their moist skin, they can do the respiration whenever they are in the water. So this is about what? Respiration in the frog. Now we will see the next one, that is what? Respiration in fish. So as we know, what is the habitat of the fish? The fish is living in the water, and we have an idea about that. What? The oxygen is also get mixed into the water. Okay. So the dissolved oxygen, the whatever the oxygen is dissolved in the water, that oxygen is get utilized by the fish to do the respiration process. Okay. But to do that respiration process, the fish are having the very special respiratory organ, that is nothing but what? Gills. Okay, that is nothing but what? Gills. So with the help of the gills, the fish are doing the respiration process. Okay. If you have observed the fish in the fish tank, you can see that the fish is continuously doing the movement of their mouth. Why is it so? Have you ever seen? Okay, I will give the answer for that. Why the fish is continuously moving their mouth? Because with the help of that mouth, they are taking the inside water. Okay, and with that water, they are taking the inside oxygen also. Just now we said that what the oxygen is get dissolved in the water. So along with the water, they are taking the oxygen, and the gills are having the well supplied blood cells. Okay, so on the both the side of the head of the fish, there are the gills, and these gills are well supplied with the blood cells. Okay, so that fish is continuously moving their mouth, and with that they are taking inside the water. From that water, the gills extract the oxygen, or we can say that the gills absorb the oxygen and then transport it to the different body parts. Okay, again, that when the oxygen will get reached to the different body parts, there will be the respiration process, breakdown of the food will happen, and release the carbon dioxide and the energy. And again, that carbon dioxide reaches to the gills, and the carbon dioxide throwing out with the help of the gills only. So, in this way, with the help of the gills, the fish is also doing the respiration process. Okay, so up till now, we have seen the different organisms and their respiratory organs. Okay, we have seen the respiration in the insects. So the insects are doing the respiration with the help of the trachea and the spiracles. Respiration in the earthworm, they are doing with the moist skin. Frogs are having the pair of lungs, which is used when they are on the land. Also, they are doing the respiration with the help of the moist skin whenever they are in the water. Also, we have seen the respiration in the fish. So the fish are doing the respiration with the help of their gills. Now we will move on the next one, that is we will see the respiration in plants. Okay, is the plants are also doing respiration? Yes, the plants are also doing the respiration, because like us, the plants are also the living things. Okay, and the respiration is one of the characteristics of a living being. Okay, or the living things, we can say that. So like the other living organism, the plants are also doing the respiration, and like other organism, plants are also taking inside oxygen and release the carbon dioxide during the process of respiration. Okay, so my dear student, don't get confused over here. Whenever the plants are performing the photosynthesis, okay, whenever the plants are performing the photosynthesis, they take inside carbon dioxide and release the oxygen. Okay, but when the plants are doing the respiration process, carbon dioxide. Okay, but the question is that is the plant needs the energy? Yes, obviously if there is a living thing, then obviously they requires the energy. So to fulfill the need of the energy, the plants are also doing the respiration. For that respiration, they are taking the oxygen inside. That oxygen is get utilized to break down the food which is in the form of glucose. That food get break down, then release the energy and the carbon dioxide. And again, this carbon dioxide is thrown out from the plants. Okay. So this is the respiration in the plants. So in our previous lesson, that is in the nutrition in the plants, we have discussed that the plants' leaves are having the tiny pores over it, and the tiny pores are called as what? Stomata. Okay. So the tiny pores are called as stomata. So the exchange of the gases for the photosynthesis also and for the respiration also takes place through the stomata. Okay. So the exchange of the gases can take place in the plant with the help of the tiny opening which are present on the leaves, which are called as what? Stomata. Now the next one, as we know, if there is a root system or the all the roots of the plants, there are so many small hair-like structure which we are calling as what? Root hair. Okay. So like the other parts of the plants, the root of the plants also requires the energy, and for that the root are also performing the respiration process through the tiny hairs present on the root, which are called as what? Root hair. Okay. But from where the root hair is getting the air? Yes, the question is valid. As we know, in the soil there are the certain space, and that space is get filled with the air. Okay, the space between the soil is get filled with the air. There is a space between the soil particle, and that soil particle or the space between the soil particle is get filled with the air. So that air is get utilized by the root hair for the process of respiration. They take inside oxygen and release the carbon dioxide through these root hair. Okay, so this is the respiration in the plants. Also in certain plants, or we can say that also in the mature plants or on the herbs, on their barks there are the small openings, or there are the tiny pores are present on the bark of the plants. Okay, and the tiny pores are called as what? Lenticles. Okay, so where are the lenticles present? Lenticles are present on the bark region. Okay, lenticles are present on the bark region. What is meant by the lenticles? Lenticles are the small opening or the small pores, tiny pores which are present on the upper surface of the bark of the tree. Okay, so with the help of the lenticles also the plants are doing the respiration process. Okay, so this is all about the plants, how the plants are doing the respiration process. Okay, so here we have discussed all the points from the lesson. Here we have completed this lesson, that is what? Respiration in organisms. Okay, so here we will stop. We'll meet in the next video with the next point and the new lesson. And for today,